Assalamualaikum everyone. Okay, so this is Ms. Naziha. We are going to learn today the valuation of freehold interest, particularly the valuation of vacant possession. So let's begin our class for today with Ummu Kitab Al-Fatiha. Okay, for freehold interest valuation, there are two situations. Okay, the first one where the situation would be the freehold with vacant possession, and the second one would be the freehold subject to lease. Okay, so let's go to the first one, the freehold interest, right rented. So right rented is also known for rental value. Okay, so in order to do the valuation for freehold vacant possession, what we are going to need is the formula of rental value multiplied by years purchase in perpetuity at ARY. Okay, so let's look at the example for the calculation. The rental value is 60,000 per annum net, and then we are going to multiply by years purchase in perpetuity at ARY. So ARY in the question in this situation would be 8%. So we are going to use the formula 1 divided by I, so Y divided by 0.08, and then you will get 12.5. Okay, so 60,000 multiplied by 12.5, the capital value of freehold interest with vacant possession would be 750,000 ringgit. Okay, so when are we going to use this formula? We are going to use this formula when the property is owner occupied. When the owner buy the property, the owner did not lease it out, but instead he occupied the property. Okay, so in this case, we are going to use the freehold vacant possession. Second one would be the property is vacant. The property is empty. The property is ready to be let. Okay, so if the property is vacant, then we are going to use the freehold vacant possession. And last one, when the property has been tenanted, okay, but the rental would be reviewed every year. So if the property is let with annual review, that means every year the rental would be reviewed to the rental value. So every year the rental is different because it will be reviewed to the rental value. Okay, so in these three situations whereby the owner occupied, vacant, and also if the property has tenant but it is annual review, we need to use the freehold of vacant possession. Okay, right, so moving on to the second one, that would be the reversionary or the freehold subject to lease. So basically means that the owner let his or her property to a tenant. Okay, so normally the rental would be less than the current rental value. If that's the case, then we are going to use the term and reversion methods. Okay, so in order to do the freehold term and reversion valuation, let's revise back the four term. The rent received will be multiplied by 1p single rate, and we are going to use a lower yield, okay, for term. So normally we have to reduce 1% from the ARY, and for reversion, the rental value will be multiplied by YP reversion to perpetuity, and we are going to use all this yield during the reversion, and then you will get, once you total up or sum up the term and reversion, you will get the capital value of freehold subject to lease. Okay? Okay, to make sure that you understand the lesson for today, then you are going to answer the tutorial. Okay, so for question number one, you need to value the freehold interest. Okay, given would be the rental value is 400 ringgit per month, and the landlord is responsible for all expenses. Okay, and then the question also give you the property yield of 8%, and then the following details of rates, repairs, insurance, quit rent, and management are also given. Okay, so once you're done, then you have to submit the tutorial question to me. Okay, Okay, so we have another two more questions for tutorial. So question number two is about the owner of the commercial property, it is owner occupied. And question number three, it has been rented out but at a rental value. However, the landlord is responsible for all outgoings. Okay, so again, calculate the capital value of this pre-owned interest. Okay, so this will be the last question for tutorial, question number four. Okay, so for question number four, it is about a freeholder who let his property for 8 years at a rental of 4,000 ringgit per month net. However, the lease has started since 3 years ago. Okay, the rental value would be 4,500 ringgit and the all received is 8%. So you need to calculate the capital value of this pre-owned interest. If you're not sure, then please refer to the previous video on how to do the valuations for pre-owned interest, particularly for term and reversion. Okay, so you have four questions for tutorial, and don't forget to submit it to me. We are going to discuss the answer in our class. Okay, good luck!